Okay, today I would like to practice some with you guys, some Boogaloo moves. Since it's very hard to do the Boogaloo, and even it's very hard to get the concept of what is Boogaloo, okay? Definitely, Boogaloo Moves is not Boogaloo, right? Honestly speaking, I really, I don't know why the rolls are called the Boogaloo rolls. It's just rolls, right? Okay, so what I told you about the Boogaloo is the positions, the postures. You don't go straight like this. You make various angles. So if your face is facing that way, your shoulder facing this way, your knees this way, okay? All of your body parts are facing different directions, okay? And one of the things is there should be balance, right? So it should be like this, alright? Balanced, verified angles. This is what I would say, what Boogaloo is. I first got the concept of Boogaloo in 2005, okay? I was just hopping in a club and I thought from dancing here, I went here and I thought, wow, this feels a little bit similar to what I saw in Boogaloo Sam's dance. So, one thing very important about the Boogaloo is you should go down, okay? Your angles should be various. That's the basic principle. And to do that, don't just be standing all the time. You go down, right? And when I tell people or the dancers to go down, they go down and then up again. Down and up again. No, right? When you go down, you can play there for a while, and then you can come back up. Not down and up and dancing and down and then up, right? So going down is what is important, and a lot of dancers don't do. And one other thing. Alright, this is called trunk position. I don't know why, but Skeeter Rabbit calls it trunk positions. But a lot of people think that when you boogaloo, you should be in this position. And when somebody, when some hoppers do boogaloo, a lot of them stay in this position. A lot of, a long time, the most of the time they dance, they are in this position. Okay, this looks stupid, right? Although you can go prone, right? You can have your, you can bring your body deep down. Your moves can go deep when you go down the shoulders, okay? But as I told you, the basic principle is to verify the angles. So don't stay there for more than necessary, all right? You go, you crump, go deep, you're going to come up again. Soon. Two, And if you want to go various, okay, you should shift the weight. Shift the weight. If you don't shift the weight, your moves will be plain. Shift. To do that, what I told you is tilt. Instead of just dancing straight, you tilt. Moves. Moves. Tilt your body, right? Instead of just doing 2D, down straight like this. Okay, so let's try to make the moves then. Verified angles. One of the points is a lot of dancers have their head straight like this all the time. They move their arms and legs but no head. Okay? So in Boogaloo, what is the basic principle? Verify the angles. So what you do is you move a lot of your head rather than just having it straight like this for all time, right? Weight shifting, right? From here to here. Weight shifting. Flex. You prop and then you go straight again. Rolls, tilt, weight shifting, go down, and have your body moving as well, your chest and everywhere. Okay? Don't just be arms and legs. Don't just be arms and legs. Your chest. You can have it lifted like this, or prone. Verify the angles. Go down. Okay? See? Not plain, but verify angles. Go up and down, move your head, roll. When you tilt, you can roll. And I told you about keeping the feeling, right? Like when you go here, you can keep this for a while. But just for a while, just as long as necessary. Don't be in this position all the time, right? Keep, then release. Anticipate what you're going to do, but have it various tilts. Concept. What is Boogaloo?
Okay.
All right. So you can practice these, and until then, goodbye.